TV presenter and junior medico Henimoa Holmes is 30 today. On this day in 1949, New Zealand's first commercial recording, Karaitiana's Blue Smoke, was released. And Stevie Ray Vaughan would have been 41 today.
Hey, welcome back here with Meat Night. Tonight we're joined by the man who has sold more records than he's had hot dinners, although he's named after a dish that's usually served cold. It all started with the Bat Outta Hell album in 1977, which is still the longest charting record in history, selling 24 million copies. Six noughts. Meat arrived in New Zealand today. It's his new album. Welcome to the neighbourhood. It's the record stores. Meat, thanks for coming along.
Normally served cold?
Meatloaf.
It is?
Yeah. Did you not know that? Here it is.
Oh, it is?
Always. A 21st, 20 big occasion, you get the meatloaf. Bottles of beer
on
and Pavlova.
On what occasion? What occasion?
A 21st. That's like a coming of age ritual in
New
Zealand.
2 years ago when we were on the radio, I'm absolutely convinced that we were talking about this during the commercial break, and I finally get an opportunity to sit behind a news desk, wear my glasses, and look.
You look regal. Look, yeah, apart. I said that. Yeah.
But anyway, back to what I was talking about. You didn't mumble 2 years ago, Marcus.
I don't think I mumble now.
You don't?
Your
so
ears
far,
have slowed down.
So far, Marcus.
Between and there, it's your ears.
No, so far, Marcus, you've said to me about five things that I've had to go, what? And my wife would be here going, no, you don't say what, you say excuse me.
Mate, as you get older in life, things slow down and you're not hearing me as quick or as clearly.
I see. So you're telling me that I'm old now, Marcus.
I'm not telling you you're old, but you're telling me a mumbler and I'm taking some sort of offense to it. Now, your vocal range. I read somewhere you've got the largest vocal range of any known musical performer. Like a Helgen tenor or something.
Where did you read this piece of information? Yeah, I'm an owl, okay?
In the New Zealand Herald.
Well, it just goes to show you can't believe everything you read.
In the New Zealand.
You knew that.
Have you got a very long vocal range? Like there's some
long? You mean wide? Whatever it is.
I mean, spanning.
No, it's okay. It's not extraordinary. It's average, I think.
But are there special parts in opera that only you can sing?
Well, Helden tenor. No, what it really means, what a Helden tenor means, is that you sing higher than it sounds.
Just give me an example.
Oh, shut up, Marcus.
Give me an example.
Day I will make it come again.
Thank you.
Now, those were very high notes, but it just didn't sound that way.
So they're very high, but they seem low.
That's right, and loud.
So it's a dramatic effect.
That's right. So there you are. Now, see, I sing with Pavarotti.
Really?
You know what he did to me?
What?
Oh, listen, this guy's a little weasel. Well, he's a big weasel, actually.
Pavarotti's a weasel? Tell me.
Well, he was okay. He's a nice guy, but I think he's a little paranoid, you know?
Because of your talent?
No, I think he's paranoid of anyone's talent. He did this to me. He said to me, he wanted me to sing a song with him, right?
Yeah. Like, but he asked you, he phoned up and said, mate, come and sing with me.
Well,
it was his call.
Yeah, he kept calling me, but see,
you,
I'm
right?
in this, I'm kind of weird, like if a celebrity calls me, I get really nervous, and I don't know what to say to them, and I panic, somebody will call me, and my wife will say, blah, 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 is on the phone, and I'll go, I can't talk to him, you talk to him. And so Pavarotti called me up on the phone.
At home.
He called me, I answered the phone. And I hear this voice go, in Italian, is Meatloaf there? And I go, who's calling? And he said, Luciano Pavarotti. And I went, no, I'm not here. No, I said, no, he's not here. He's at this number. And I hung up. So I go to the other number, and they call me. And eventually, I was forced to talk to him. And I was really nervous. So then when I got to him, I finally said, okay. He said, sing this song, come back to Sorrento. I said, okay. So we started searching for versions. We found a version by Dean Martin that was all, you know, like, I couldn't understand what he was saying. He's a mumbler like you are.
Pavarotti's a mumbler. Yeah.
No, not Pavarotti, Dean Martin.
Dean Martin. Wait,
and so then finally what we come to the conclusion, okay, that I'm going to do come back to Sorrento with Pavarotti. So I learn it in one key, and I get there, and I'm very loud. And so I sing like two bars of this song, and all of a sudden, they all start talking in Italian. Blah, 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 blah. You know, forget about it, Angelo. Forget about it. And
so then, for the long story.
So it is a long story. It's longer than four. That's right, it is. But that's okay. It's a good story.
Okay.
So anyway, the bottom line is he lowers the key for me and keeps the same key for him.
Is that right?
Yeah, so that he thought he was going to be louder than me.
So that's
I was louder than him in the lower key. There you go.
So you did him.
Yeah, but I can't. I mean, why should he care? I mean, he's an incredible singer. I didn't say I was a better singer. I just was as loud. So that's the interview, and you know what?
Now tonight's information off-ramp.
That's right. Damn information off-ramp. Here we go. Well, guess who holds the world's record for the 4x100-yard relay? Orenthal James Simpson. Yes, the very same O.J. who's cooling his heels at the moment waiting for the verdict. The record still stands as a distance isn't run anymore, but O.J. was a bat out of hell in his day, holding the relay record on three different occasions.
Everyone that comes on is better than me. Are we a sport mad nation? Of course we bloody are. A new hillside subdivision in Christchurch has been named after New Zealand America's cup skipper. Now, it's not Coots Court or Blake's backyard, but for a few thousand you can move into Eggnot Heights, named after Christchurch only as the Eggnot, who skippered for the other side in the Defender Series. And if you're lucky, you might just spare an address in Defender or Challenger Lane. Leslie named the streets herself.
You know what? Look at this. Here's some new Coke bottles that look very much like the old ones. Yes, but in response to customers' demand, Coke has released the original shape.
It's re-released.
Yeah, okay, they re-released it. Re-released the original shape. You get a bit less than you than what? Go ahead, you finish it now.
You get a bit less than the can though, and if you haven't got a bottle opener, you're stuffed.
Although
you shouldn't use your teeth.
When I was younger, I used my teeth. I never saw though written that way. It totally confused me that though.
Don't do
there.
That. But it's good in the bottles, eh?
And it's great. That's the best way to have Coke is in a bottle.
Excellent.
That's it. That's it. We did that well, Marcus.
We're a duo, eh?
That's right. That's right.
I'll be packing my bags and coming on the road.
That's right. That's right.
And I won't even go home.
Should we just switch? And
yeah.
Can I have that little thing you got in your ear?
That's yeah, you can,
I don't
sure.
have one of those. They didn't give me one of those.
If you really want it?
Oh, no, I don't. Oh, is it Kim's turn yet?
That's tonight's information off-ramp. Here's Kimmy with tomorrow's weather.
Oh, I can't wait. I can't wait. I'm going to be here tomorrow.
Thank you, Marcus. Thank you, Meat. That's been
so much fun.
Great. But just when you thought the weather was on the up, the north's going to be coated in rain as a strong nor'easter picks up. Place to be is Gisborne. It'll be 20 and should be shower-free. And brollies and coats needed in the south too, with widespread rain from top to bottom. Blenheim looks good on 18, but will cop a drop or two by evening.
No, there's not much for the south on, was there? Hey, on tomorrow's show, we unmask this mysterious man, this mysterious nightclub sensation, who goes by the name of Killer Ray.
Hi-ho, Silver! Away!
He's good, eh?
He sounds good, Killer Ray. He's very good.
He's a New Zealand jazz musician.
That's right. Yeah. So anyway, I know we didn't talk about the new album at all.
But we're going to play a bit of it now.
We are.
And
from Welcome to the Neighborhood.
Yep.
Welcome to the Neighborhood. I'd lie for you and that's the truth.
And you're going to come back and play it? I mean, you're going to come back and tour?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Oh, yeah.
You're not just here talking.
No, I'm not just here talking. We're back and playing sooner than you can say Bob White.
Who's he?
It's a bird.
Oh, okay. We've got to go.
Let's hear it.
Here's a
good
bit of
night.
Good night. Bye-bye. Thanks very much.
Thank you.